identify 15 over 8, or 15 eighths, as a proper or improper fraction. So proper fraction just means that the numerator is equal or less than or equal to the denominator. So proper fraction, numerator, the number on top, is less than or equal to the denominator. And an improper fraction, the numerator is greater than the denominator. And we see in our example right here, our numerator is greater than our denominator. So we are dealing with an improper fraction. Now, a more interesting question is, what does 15 eighths even represent? So let's think about that a little bit. We saw in the last couple of videos that the denominator tells you essentially how many slices of pie there are, I guess is one way to think about it. So let me draw something with 8. Let me divide something in, maybe we could view this as a square pizza or a square pie of some kind. So let's say that's the entire pie. I'm dividing it into, well, that would be dividing it into 2. That would divide it into 4. And then to divide it into 8, I'd be just like that. So this would be one whole pie. Now, what does one of these boxes represent? What does that box right there represent? Well, we've seen this is one of the 8 total pieces of pie. So this represents 1/8. Now, if I were to shade in blue, let's say in blue I were to shade in this box and that box right there. And I were to say, what fraction of my pie is shaded in blue? Well, you'd say, I have 2 boxes shaded in blue, 1, 2. I have 2 boxes shaded in blue out of a total of 8 boxes. These two right here are 2/8 of the entire pie. Or another way to think about it, this is equal to 2 of these pieces, right? So you could say this is also equal to 2 times 1/8. Because each of these boxes right here is 1/8. We saw that right there. It is one of the total 8 pieces. And so this 2 of the 8, that's really just 2 of these 1/8 boxes. Now, if everything I've just said makes sense, let's think about what 15/8 mean. So if you imagine these boxes like that, let's try to do 15/8. So if you were to draw, so that's 1/8 right there. I'm going to do the same size as these boxes. And let me copy and paste this. So let me copy, and then let me paste. So then that would be 2/8. Let me do 3/8. And then 4. We're going to go all the way up to 15. Hope it doesn't bore you. That is 5, 6, 7, 8. And now we've made a whole pie, but we're only at 8. We have to get to 15. So then let's keep going. So then we're going to start another pie. So it's 1, 2, 3. So far, how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So what have I just drawn here with all these pink squares? Each of these is 1/8. Each of these boxes is 1/8 of a pie, I guess is how you could think about it. This is 1/8. And I've just drawn 15 times 1/8. So all of these combined are 15 times 1/8. Or we could say that this is also equal to, if we just use the logic we did before, 15 over 8. Now, how many pies do I have here? Well, these first 8 of the 15, this right here, that is 8 out of 8, or 8 1/8, and that's equal to one whole pie. So this right here is equal to 1. That right there is equal to 1. And what do we have over here? We have one whole pie, 8 out of 8 of pieces of a potential pie, or 8 out of 8 1/8 of a pie, I guess you could call it. And then over here we have 7/8 of a pie, right? You can imagine a whole pie would involve another grid right there. would involve one more over here. But this is 7 out of the 8. So this right here, let me do this in another color, this piece right here represents 7. 7 times 1/8, or 7/8. So if you were to say what 15 over 8 kind of represents, it represents one whole pie, and then 7/8 of another pie. And you can even write that down as a mixed number. And it's a mixed number because it has a whole number and a fraction. So this is equal to one whole pie. This is equal to one whole pie right there, and 7/8 of another pie. And 7/8 of another pie. And that's all it represents when you think about what 15/8 means. Now, I had to draw it out like this, but a quick way you can do to solve this is to divide 8 into 15. So if you were to take, let me do this with new colors. So if you were to take it 8 right there, you divide 8 into 15, you see that it's equal to, well, 8 goes into 15 one time, because 2 times 8 is 16, so that's too big. So 1 times 8 is 8. You subtract 15 minus 8 is 7. So to get 1 and 7/8, this one right here, so you get one whole 8 in there. If you have 15/8, you get a whole 8 in there, and then you have 7 left over. But these are 7/8. So that's where that 7/8 come from. You have to write the remainder over 8. Hopefully you found that helpful.